Welcome to Facts TV News, where everything is true. St. Anne farmer chopped to death. A 52-year-old farmer of Lossington in Montmorency, St. Anne, was chopped to death on January 25th. He has been identified as Glenroy Campbell, otherwise called Glenn. Police reports are that about 4 p.m., Campbell was in his community when he was attacked by a man who chopped him multiple times. The police were alerted and Campbell was taken to hospital, where he was pronounced dead. A man has been taken into custody in relation to the killing. Manchester man charged with killing brother visiting from UK. A Manchester man has been charged with the January 19 murder of his brother, who was visiting from the United Kingdom. The deceased has been identified as 48-year-old UK resident Michael Brown. Police theorized that an alleged family dispute over land and houses was a possible motive in the killing of Brown in Mytown in the parish. Charged with murder is 38-year-old Lemon Brown, a carpenter and resident of Loveland in Mytown. Michael Brown, otherwise called Jimmy, was shot and killed about 12:20 a.m. while in bed, 4 days after laying his 74-year-old mother to rest. Head of the Manchester Police Superintendent Shane McCullough last week told reporters that the police have intervened in the alleged dispute over land days before the murder. In a press release on Thursday, police said, concentrated evidence led to the arrest and charge of Lemon Brown, whose court date is currently being finalized. Indicom probing incident at Otteres police lockup, which left at least one inmate injured. The Independent Commission of Investigations, Indicom, has launched a probe into an incident at the Otteres police lockup in St. Anne on January 25th. At least one detainee was injured during the incident. Videos of what appeared to be a bloodstained jail cell with detainees complaining about being hurt have been circulating on social media. It was also reported that there was a standoff between cops and detainees because the detainees objected to a routine search. This resulted in the station yard being closed and the Otteres Fire Brigade and the military being called in for support. Police said the disturbance occurred about 3:15 p.m. when the cell search was being undertaken and the prisoners became boisterous. Deputy Superintendent of Police Kevin Chambers said the matter was brought under control quickly and normality was restored. The search was carried out in the wake of a recent altercation, during which a group of prisoners allegedly attacked another, wounding him. 5 inmates have been charged with assault arising from the alleged attack.
Police were conducting routine cell search at the Otteres police station when inmates from a section of the cell resisted to be searched. And there was a standoff. A officer was attacked and necessary force had to be used to subdue a particular prisoner. He was taken to hospital where he was treated and released into custody. The situation was brought under control with support from other resources in the division, and the situation is back to normal.
Scores of commuters in St. Anne and Clarendon were stranded yesterday morning following another protest over bad roads and insufficient water supply. MP promises to address issues. Scores of students were among commuters in sections of St. Anne and Clarendon who were left stranded on January 26 following another protest over the bad road conditions and insufficient water. Irritated residents from several communities took the Alston Main Road to register their anger over what they have described as unfulfilled promises regarding their concerns. The residents say they were told last week that the issues would be addressed, but so far, nothing has been done. One resident, Brian Hyman, told reporters that a meeting between citizens and political representatives was scheduled for last evening. He called on Member of Parliament for Clarendon Northwestern, Philip Henriquez, to do more to improve the condition of the roadways and to ensure there is sufficient water supply.
We scheduled a meeting for Wednesday, which was yesterday, and Tuesday evening, about 4:30, he called to cancel his arrival to the meeting, have a major roadblock because he didn't attend our meeting. So the caretaker was supposed to come to the meeting, the police was supposed to come to the meeting, and the councillor was supposed to come to the meeting. We had to cancel all of them. We don't have any water. We live between two pump houses, and we don't have any water. And the water pump miles upon miles away from us, and we don't have any. And we live between two pump houses, and we don't have any good road, and we don't have a street light. Our community is pitch black at night, and we don't have any representative, Mr. Henriquez, Philip Henriquez, which they say he is the MP. We don't know him. He doesn't come in the constituency. So we had invited him to a meeting so that we could share our views with him, and he don't turn up.
Meantime, MP Henriquez has sought to assure residents that he is working to improve road conditions and water supply in the constituency. When asked by reporters about his failure to attend the scheduled meeting with residents about the matter last evening, Mr. Henriquez explained that he communicated his unavailability but arranged for a representative to attend. He said while he understands the residents' frustration, the issues cannot be fixed immediately.
A meeting was set for yesterday. Unfortunately, I was not able to go to the meeting yesterday, and I informed them of that from the day before, 2 days before. And I said I would send my representative, who is the councillor caretaker, to meet and at least discuss, start the discussion until I was able to set a new date, which was hopefully next week. I also would be having a visit and a tour with the minister of in charge of roads over the weekend so that I can impress on him and show him some of the problems that we're having to see what he can do to assist. It was the choice of the people, whoever the key advisors or whoever set up the meeting, they made the choice to postpone the meeting. I did not do so. I really do understand their frustration. But what has been destroyed over 20 years of neglect by past MPs, I cannot fix everything in 2 years. What I can say to the people and show them is that work is being done and we are moving forward and their time will come as soon as possible. Now, over the Christmas, as I told you, through the National Works Agency, we repaired some of the road up at Cedar Square coming down towards Dalton School. So there is action being taken, and there is some funds being spent there within the limits that we have. So it is not that anybody has been ignoring them or anybody has not been working. It is just that we're not able to do the entire road at this time, and I have to continue my consultations and speak with the government to see what possibilities are available and as quickly as possible try to address the situation. But I can't do any more than that right now.
Reebok charged with murder of St. Anchev. A man has been charged with murder in relation to an incident that took place on Hunter Crescent, Brownstone in St. Anne on Saturday, August 13, 2022. Charges 18-year-old Joshua Miller, otherwise called Reebok, of Trickett's Place in Kingston. Dead is 63-year-old Orville Brown, a chef of Belle Runaway Bay in St. Anne. Reports are that about 4 p.m., Miller and his accomplices contacted Brown and allegedly made arrangements to meet with him. Miller and the other men then lured Brown onto Huntley Crescent with the intention to rob him of his personal items. The men accosted Brown with a knife and proceeded to rob him. A struggle ensued, during which Miller and his accomplices stabbed Brown several times. Brown was taken to hospital where he was pronounced dead. An investigation was launched and Miller was arrested. He was subsequently charged after a question and answer session in the presence of his attorney. Man charged with stealing TV, liquor and cash from St. Elizabeth Bar. A man has been charged following a shop breaking in Mount Prospect, Manchester on Wednesday, January 18. Charged with shop breaking and larceny is 26-year-old Kerry Simpson, otherwise called Buffy or Alex, of Ballard Valley District in Junction, St. Elizabeth. Reports are that a man securely locked up his bar about 10 p.m. Upon his return, it was discovered that culprits gained entry by cutting the locks on the door. Several items, including an assortment of liquor, a smart television, poker boxes, and cash were missing. A report was made to the police and an investigation launched. Simpson was later found that day with several of the items that were identified by the bar's owner. Warmington blasts former GLP leader Bruce Golding for attacking government. Minister without portfolio in the Ministry of Economic Growth and Job Creation, Edward Warmington, has blasted former Prime Minister and former Jamaica Labour Party leader Bruce Golding over his criticism of the Prime Minister Andrew Holness-led administration. Mr. Warmington has expressed displeasure at what he described as attack from the former leader. Mr. Golding has recently shared his views on the fraud scandal at Stock and Securities Limited, SSL, in a radio interview, during which he asserted that the government bears some responsibility as it provided the institution with a license to operate. But Mr. Warmington has taken issue with the assertion. What on earth does the government have to do with SSL? He reiterated, adding that it's a private investment entity. He said Mr. Golding should follow the example of former leaders of other political parties and seek to have private dialogue versus making public utterances. I have never heard P.J. Patterson or Portia Simpson Miller attack their own government their party regardless of how unpopular it was. So I believe if there's an issue, Bruce Golding, who has been a former leader, a former prime minister, should call on Your Holiness and talk to him behind closed doors. Mr. Warmington called the former leader's comment an attack indirectly on Prime Minister, my government and my party. But the outspoken minister vowed he will defend the Jamaica Labour Party and Your Holiness administration and Prime Minister and Your Holiness by any means necessary. He was speaking while on a tour of Northeast St. Elizabeth on Wednesday. Mr. Warmington has cautioned that his position towards Mr. Golding is entirely his own view and does not reflect the views of the Jamaica Labour Party.
Please remember to subscribe, like, share, and click the notification bell.